Welcome to the Media Pros Show, the show that gives you quick, simple tips to grow your business by serving as an expert on your topic in the media. Learn how to get all the magazine, newspaper, podcast, radio, TV, and online interviews and media appearances that you want, and learn how to be great in those media appearances. I'm Dr. David Geyer, orthopedic surgeon, sports medicine specialist, and media medical expert. Today, we're going to talk about radio interviews and specifically what type of equipment, i.e. phone, that you need. And yeah, that actually matters a lot. And before you ask, yes, radio is still important. Radio can be a very valuable tool to grow your business. Maybe in one of our future episodes, I'll list all the reasons why radio isn't dead, despite what you might have heard. But just understand, doing radio interviews in your town can be very helpful to get more customers, clients, and patients. Quite simply, the biggest reason is that radio is one of the few media, podcasts would be the other one, it's one of the few that actually reaches people while they're in their cars. Remember, you can't watch TV while you're driving. You can't scroll through social media while you're driving. In most states, you can't text or call people on the phone while you're driving. And remember this, 128 million people drive to work and drive home from work each weekday in their cars. That's a huge, huge potential captive audience that you could tap into to help people and get more customers, clients, and patients. So radio can be very, very valuable. Doing radio interviews in your town can be extremely helpful to help you grow your business. And there's a lot that goes into a successful radio interview. There's the topic that you pitch. There's your message and talking points, your call to action, your relationship with the host and the producer. And I can help you with all that. But what I want to talk about today specifically is what type of equipment you should use for your radio interview. And if there's one thing that I want you to remember from this podcast episode, it's this. Never use a cell phone for your radio interview. Or only use it as an absolute, absolute last resort. Now, why do I say that? Well, first of all, whenever you do a radio interview by cell phone, your audio quality will be terrible. Just trust me on that, it will be. You have to remember, the host almost always is in studio unless they're on location somewhere. So they're in a room that's soundproofed and has all the sound insulation, has a professional mic, has a producer doing the audio quality. That host, he or she's gonna sound terrific. You need to sound as good as you possibly can. You want the listener focused on your message and what you're trying to explain to him or her, or what you're trying to offer him or her. If they can't understand you, if they can't even hear you, then your message isn't going to land. All those benefits of a radio interview are gone. Plus, let's face it, cell calls drop all the time. Doesn't matter where you live, how big the city, cell signal quality is extremely variable. A few years ago, I was supposed to do an interview on Sirius XM talking about NFL injuries that had occurred, you know, earlier that weekend. It was a 1-hour show. And the first half of the show, they were going to interview another sports medicine doctor, Dr. Gene Bramble, real good guy. The second half of the show, they were going to interview me. One of the things I like to do, you know, ahead of a radio interview is I'll listen a little bit ahead of time, find out what the hosts are like, kind of the feel of the show, the give and take, that kind of thing. So I listened to the first half of the show online, listening to what Gene had to say. Plus, by hearing what he had to say, I could potentially avoid things and making the same point, or I could potentially reference something he said. So I wanted to prepare. All I remember from his interview, I mean, literally the only thing I remember was that he was on a cell phone. He sounded terrible. There'd be these 3 to 5 second gaps where you couldn't hear anything. You'd hear the host say, "Dr. Bramble, are you there?" over and over. I mean, they were really frustrated. And then at some point, the call dropped completely. They were not happy. Now, it was good for me because I got an extra 15 minutes to my part of the interview, but really, really looked and sounded unprofessional. Now, whenever you can, do everything you can to avoid using a cell phone. If you have to, let me give you an idea. I do a weekly radio show on the largest sports talk radio station here in Charleston, South Carolina, and it's the most popular show. Do it every week, Wednesdays at 5:25. I always, if I can, and this 9 out of 10 times, I do it from my home office using a landline phone. But occasionally there'll be a reason that I can't. I'm traveling or I'm somewhere that I just can't get away and I'll have to use a cell phone. I'll let them know ahead of time. I email the host and say, hey, I'm going to be on cell phone, just so you know. Or when I call in ahead of time and the producer answers, I say, hey, there was nothing I could do. I'm having to do this by cell phone. So if you tell the producer or host ahead of time, they might not like it, but they'll cut you some slack. They can prepare in case your audio quality is bad or in case the call drops. Now, using a landline phone will make that host and producer much happier, and you'll sound much more professional. And the last thing I'll say about landline phones is sometimes you're going to be doing a radio interview that's pre-recorded and it'll air at a later date, a later time. Maybe it's a segment that's going to air at 2 a.m. and they don't want you to have to stay up till 2 a.m. to do the interview. Or maybe it's going to be a longer interview that they chop up into segments. I do those fairly often. And so they'll pre-record it. In those situations, there is absolutely no excuse for using a cell phone. Schedule it, you know, work with the producer, schedule it at a time that you can use a landline phone. All right, let's talk about specifically what type of equipment you want. And the first is obvious. I've mentioned it a couple times. You need a landline phone, preferably a phone with a cable that connects directly into the jack. Those have the best audio quality. Now look, I get it. I know almost everybody in society has gotten rid of landline phones and decided to use cell phones. But if you're going to be doing a lot of radio interviews, invest in a landline phone and maybe a dedicated phone number, you know, through your phone company, just so that you have the best audio quality, especially if you're going to be doing them over and over again. If a landline phone is just not an option for you, consider a voice over IP line. But that assumes that you've got a very reliable and very high-speed internet connection. But, you know, voice over IP can work well. I mean, you can use Skype to call landline numbers, or you can get a dedicated voice over IP line through your internet service provider. And the last thing about equipment, if you're using a landline phone, look into a phone that actually has a headset, but make sure you test it ahead of time. In 2017, when my book was coming out, my publisher hired a publicist to get me all these interviews. And one of his focuses was on a lot of sports talk radio shows, big cities, national networks, things like that, because it was a sports book on sports injuries. And the first day, because I had like 20 to 30 interviews that he scheduled over like a 10-day period. The first day, the first morning, I had one of the biggest morning talk shows in Los Angeles first, and then almost immediately a smaller market show, Oklahoma City, that I was going to do. Now, because I had 20 or 30 interviews, you know, different radio shows and radio stations, I bought a really expensive phone that had a headset. So the morning of that first interview, the producer in LA calls me. And, you know, I'm wearing my headset and we're testing the audio quality. And he clearly is frustrated with me. He asks why there's an echo. And I tell him, I don't know. I don't hear an echo. So I finished that. Again, I was a little disgruntled, but he agreed to do it. Again, I didn't even know what sounded bad, but he didn't think it sounded good. And then I go do the Oklahoma City interview. One of the things I like to do with any type of interview, but radio in particular, is I'll try to record the segment. You just go to their website, find the listen online, and I try to record it so that I can play it back later and try to improve. So I listen to the episode in Los Angeles, listen to the one in Oklahoma City, and there was a noticeable difference in audio quality. It actually sounded a lot better to have the phone up to my ear than it did with a headset. Now, headsets can actually sound great. Just test it out. Make sure there's no feedback or no delay or poor audio quality before you do your radio interview. And let me give you one last pro tip. It's one that a lot of times I'll forget to do, but turn off call waiting. You know, for one thing, a lot of times the listener will actually hear the click or the beep from your call waiting, but even if they can't, that incoming call, just for a split second, is probably going to distract you and get you off message, or maybe keep you from hearing what the host is saying or the question the host asks. It sounds really awkward, and you really want to try to avoid that. So there's a few things you can do. First, if you're calling into the radio station, dial *70 and then the phone number. That turns off call waiting for the duration of that interview, and then it comes back on, turns back on call waiting when your call and your radio interview are over. Better yet, just call the phone company and get rid of call waiting altogether. If, though, the station is calling you, and a lot of producers, a lot of big shows, and a lot of the big networks, the producer of the show will call you instead of you calling into the show. If that happens, answer the phone when the producer calls, but ask, hey, just give me a split second. Then click the other line as if you're answering a call coming in through call waiting. When you hear the dial tone, click back. That essentially ties up the line so that a second call can't come in through call waiting, your interview will go off with no incoming distractions. One of the things I do with the clients that I work with one-on-one is that you and I figure out how radio interviews can help you grow your business. We look for what shows have an audience that are perfect, what are your ideal customers or clients, what topics would appeal to that potential audience, and then craft your message and craft your talking points so that you can convert some of those listeners into customers, clients, and patients. Now, remember, both on this podcast or my website or my coaching, this is not specific business advice. It's not medical advice, legal, financial advice, any kind of specific advice. If you have specific business concerns, you need to talk to an expert in that area. But if you want to learn more, if you want to potentially get more media interviews to get more customers, clients, patients, potentially make more money and grow your business, hopefully become the go-to expert in your industry, in your town, maybe even have people come up to you at church or the gas station or the gym or the grocery store and say, hey, I heard you on the radio last night. You were fantastic and I really enjoyed it. I learned a lot. If you want that for you and your business, I can help you become a media pro. Go to my website, mediaproscoaching.com. Click to sign up for a free 30-minute strategy call with me. We'll talk about where you are in your business and what you're trying to achieve, and then we'll outline a few simple strategies to help you get some media interviews to help you try to achieve some of those goals. And while you're there, get my free ebook, The Media Pros Interview Checklist. It's a simple, handy reference, 20 to 30 tips, regardless of the type of media. It can be a TV, magazine, newspaper interview, radio, podcast. Tips to help you be great in that interview so you get asked back over and over and over. And finally, as you work to become a bigger, better, and more successful media pro, you do well to remember the words of the legendary comedian Steve Martin. Whenever someone would ask Steve Martin how they could get into comedy, his answer was always very simple. Be so good they can't ignore you.